thank you for joining me for today's episode of Turnaround Thursday. This is Reverend Tashi Campbell. In today's episode of Turnaround Thursday, we reflect on fair. Not the fair of the Lord, but fair. What are you afraid of? The Bible really talks about two types of fear. And earlier this week in morning meditation, we looked at the fear of the Lord. But today, in Turnaround Thursday, we want to look at the fear that as Christians we are not supposed to have. Let us go to the Word of God and be instructed by it. So 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7 says, "For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind." Well, my friends, I want us to pay attention to the word fear in that particular verse. The Greek word that has been translated as fear is a word that is used in extra-biblical material, extra-biblical literature, to refer to a person who flees from battle, a person who runs away, a person who has fled from battle. It is a very strong term for cowardice. So I want us to understand then, God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Well, boldness, not cowardice, is a mark of the Holy Spirit. Another version says, God has not given us the spirit to make us afraid. So we must understand then that boldness is a mark of the Holy Spirit. So the Christian who has the Holy Spirit, and all Christians do, if you're a born again Christian, you have the Holy Spirit. Fear is not of God and it's not from God. Proverbs 28 verse 1 says, "The wicked flee when no one is pursuing them, but the righteous ones, they are as bold as a lion." "For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind." What an awesome God he is. Well, only the Holy Spirit can equip us with these essential qualities. The power, the love, the sound mind. Let's look a little bit more into the Word of God. Do you remember when the disciples were out at sea and a storm came and Jesus had to step in and he said, "O ye of little faith, why are you so afraid?" And then he spoke to the storm and calmed the storm. Jesus rebuked his disciples for cowardice. I want us to remember too that the fruit of the Spirit is love. The fruit of the Spirit includes love. And the Bible says that this love displaces fear. In 1 John 4 verse 18, there is no fear in love. But perfect love drives out fear, because fear has to do with punishment. The one who fears is not made perfect in love. The one who fears is not made perfect in love. And then there is self-control. God's presence bestows courage. God's presence bestows courage. You know, as we continue to reflect on this fear, based on my understanding of the scriptures and from experience, I want to define fear. And this is how I define fear. Fear is cowardice. It is the absence of courage or boldness. And this fear, this absence of courage or boldness, this cowardice is usually facilitated by a lack of knowledge, a lack of knowledge of what God's presence in one's life can do or has done, and is usually facilitated by a lack of submission to the Holy Spirit who makes us bold, or is facilitated by a stack of excuses. Fear is sometimes a natural emotional response to an undesirable situation, whether that situation is dangerous or traumatic or otherwise. But I want us to understand, my friends, that if fear is not addressed, it can cause us to become rock-like. And by rock-like, I mean hardened and stagnant. Well, maybe God has called you to preach, but you haven't even developed the gift of speaking in public because of fear. Or perhaps you have a beautiful singing voice, but no one has heard it because of fear. It could be that you want to go back to school, you want to start writing a book, starting a business, you want to go into a particular ministry, or there's a decision for you to take, but fear has convinced you to make your bed right where you are, and you have become comfortable because of fear. My friends, has fear lured you into a place of withdrawal and has been feeding you with lies? You are not who you used to be, and certainly not who you are supposed to be because of fear. Well, my brothers and sisters in Christ, I have said it before and I will say it again. Fear is not of God. I think I will say that again. Fear is not of God. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Yes, there is no fear in love. Perfect love drives out fear, because fear has to do with punishment. The one who fears is not made perfect in love. And then listen to what God says. God says, "So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." My friends, when we hold on to fear, what are we communicating to God? When we hold on to fear, what does this communicate to others about the God that you serve? Well, perhaps you are fearful. Perhaps you have been stagnant. Perhaps you have been where you are for a long time because you have been so fearful. And you're now wondering, how can I really overcome this fear? Well, I want to make a few suggestions to you. First one is this: acknowledge that the fear exists. And if you are thinking about this question about overcoming fear, then it means that you have acknowledged the fear. So very good. You've covered step one. The next thing is to consider, to answer the question, what is feeding those fears that you have? What's feeding that fear? Could it be a lack of confidence in your ability? Maybe it's past experiences or ignorance. You have no knowledge about a particular matter and that has made you fearful. Could it be people? Sometimes people will make us feel fear. Or perhaps it's lies, false beliefs. Because we have these lies and false beliefs that we have been fed with. we are fearful. What is feeding your fear? So acknowledge that the fear exists. Answer the question, what's feeding your fear? Thirdly, eliminate the feeders of your fears. Eliminate, get rid of it. When you would have identified what's feeding your fear, then get rid of those fears, my friends. If fear is not of God, then whatever is feeding your fear could not be from God either. So eliminate the feeders of your fear. Fourthly, embrace the truth of God's word. Embrace the truth of God's word. What are those lies you have been believing? What are those false beliefs that you recognize you have? What does God have to say about these things? Read His word. Understand God's will. Find out what He has to say and embrace His truth. And then finally, put God to the test. Put God to the test. Put God to the test. Shame the devil and step out by faith. Just go ahead and do that which God has called you to do. How have you been feeding your fears? What is today's turnaround strategy? Fear not, says God. Fear will prevent you from fulfilling God's will for your life, from experiencing God's best, and from knowing the victory associated with the boldness produced by the Holy Spirit in the life of the believer. Today's turnaround strategy again. Fear not, says God, for fear will prevent you from fulfilling God's will for your life, from experiencing God's best, and from knowing the victory associated with the boldness produced by the Holy Spirit in the life of the believer. Let us pray. Indeed, God, you are faithful and you are sovereign, you are mighty, and you are true to your word. You keep your promises, and so we hold on to your promise. For you promise never to leave us nor forsake us. And Lord, you have commanded us, do not fear, because you are with us. You are our God. You are strengthening us even now and helping us and upholding us. And Lord, we are grateful. We are thankful. Forgive us, mighty God, for feeding our fears and for being so fearful when your Holy Spirit, who is with us, makes us bold. So even now, God, even though we may feel fear, we are going in the boldness and the courage that is produced by the Holy Spirit. We know, God, that you are with us because you said so in your word. And so, Lord, as we ask for your undergirding this morning, this Thursday, as we turn it around, Lord, we are declaring that we will walk in your plans and in your purpose with boldness, because you are with us. So take control, my God, our Lord and our God, as we give you the preeminence. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Can you say amen? Say amen. Amen. Have a wonderful Thursday. God bless you.